This whole video is a little bit more about like self-discovery, I think, than anything else, so I'm going to share with you guys. It's funny when you flip into somewhat survival mode. I don't mean like destitute survival. I mean, okay, look, we got a trim. We know we don't have guaranteed income coming in, or I'm sure a lot of you are there. You've been there. Or you know, like I said, this is practice. This is preparation practice. You're not going to be frivolous like maybe you would if you weren't in a preparation situation. But it's kind of funny. I've noticed kind of a flip, and I want to make sure that I don't go too far to the dark side. The flip in that I don't want to turn into just poverty mindset of oh, poor me, or oh, you know, you're deprived, and that's something I think is very important to make sure. But this is a funny, to me it's a funny flip. I don't find it bad. It could get out of hand, but I think it's kind of an interesting thing. When we, I'll be able to show you parts of the bedroom this way. Of course, again, I've told you there's no air conditioning and no heat, so this has been a great find. We actually had this in storage and found it. But there were beautiful drapes. Well, they're still here. We're going to use them. I'm going to remake them, but they weren't very functional. They didn't shut and close light out from the windows or keep the windows insulated, so I'm going to redo them. But in the midst of that, the blind cords were like super duper uber long. So I have this thing, because I intend to one day have grandchildren, that I don't like them long. I have to cut them so that there's no chance of anybody getting tangled in them. So as I did that, here's where the flip went. I was going to redo the drapes once I get some sewing time and machine here, because it's good material. It's still heavy enough to hold in some heat or hold out some cold, whichever way you want to put it. But I will redo them so that they're functional and open and shut. But in doing that, I took down some of the frillies with it, as well as cutting the cords for the... what's it called? The drapes. But I found, here's the flip. I'm not throwing these things away. And to me, yes, it's very frugal, but these were beautifully looped and decored around the drapes, and the drapes were just gorgeous window trim. But I will probably not have any good use for them for I don't know how long, because it's just kind of not my way to fluff stuff up and frill it up. I'm just a little bit more practical, I guess, and simple. But here's the bigger one that kind of freaked me out that I was doing. And I don't know, I think it's a good thing. I'm trying to make sure it doesn't flip into freakdom. But I saved all the cords from the...
Hi, kitty.
Saved all the cords from the blinds. Why? Honestly, when you are not sure whether it's going to be wise to spend $10 to get heavy twine, if you've got these for free, it makes good sense. So I'm keeping them all. And I know they're all about 3 feet long. Maybe that cat's going to come through the screen because she sees these. I think they're all about 3 feet long, maybe 2.5. So I know they can hold things down, tie things together. And they're strong because they're very strong woven. And then these little things from the blinds, I'm going to have to find a use for them. I don't know what that is. Noisemakers or something. And I don't know. This one may go in the trash. See, this may flip to freaky. So this is probably going to go in the garbage. But I do see some wise use for the cords. Because if you've gone out and bought twine, you know, and then you lose it. That's the other thing. You buy it and it gets lost somewhere. Or these things. I will not purchase something like this, but I may find a use for it. So what I'm doing is saving them. I'll be putting them in, winding them up, probably putting them in bags, and then storing them in a storage spot that I can remember. And then, you know, one day down the road, maybe I'll make a video of using these and you can go, oh, maybe she wasn't so much of a freak. There's a mentality flip. And I think you have to be very, very careful when you're in preparation or survival mode. You have to, yes, be a very good steward and utilize everything you have. But you have to also be very careful that you don't pack rat and have a poverty mindset either, because then you just, that's a downward spiral. So anyway, I'll leave you with kitties playing, because to me, that's just a happy thing. Just thought I'd share. It's kind of more philosophical than tip-wise, but I think you probably get it. Okay, come back soon. Bye. God bless.